Within Course Commons, we're actually able to preview an item before we bring it into our own course. In this lesson, we're going to look at what information is provided within that preview, both on the search screen on the course item card, as well as within the actual item descriptor page. Okay. So here I've done just a simple search for adding fractions. As well, you can see that I've narrowed it down by assignments and modules because I want to look at two different types of course items. Though if I took those away, I would have many, many more results. Now, looking at just the course item or the content item card, you can see that it's represented by an image that's chosen by the uploader, as well as it has a colored icon with the word of what type of resource that is. So for example, if this was a course or an assignment, a quiz, or an image, a different icon, a different color would be represented there. That just helps you to quickly see through the different search results. Under that is the name and the only link on the content item card that links to the preview page, the grade level that this was assigned for or identified by the author, who that author is, the number of times it was downloaded, and the number of times it was favorited. So let's go ahead and click into this resource and see what's provided in the preview screen. Now in a module, it opens up directly to what you might see if this module was in your course. And so you can see what the different items of the module are, whether they're published or not, the number of points, as well as some of the details that were provided in those assignments. Over on the left, you can see the different menu items similar to your own course, whether whatever is provided within this particular module. So this module has pages and it has quizzes and files. If we go over to details, we can see a summary of the item that the author has written up to give us just a sense of what is provided there. We have a clickable link for the author's name. If we were to click that, it would take us to a search for just that author and all the other resources by that author, as well as a clickable link for whatever account, district, organization, university that that person is a part of when they created and uploaded this resource. Following that, you see that we have an again with the grade level, and then the tags that were assigned to this resource so that it could be found easier, and then who it was shared with, whether it was shared within a school district, public, et cetera, et cetera. Down here at the bottom is an opportunity for those that download and use this resource to actually come back and review it. This is a great and yet not much used resource for Course Commons. We tend to be takers, but not givers. And so I really encourage you that if you've used a resource, come back and leave a review. That helps the author that created that resource, but it also helps other educators that are looking at these resources and wondering whether or not they should use it for themselves. Going back up here to the top, we just see some statistics. For example, the number of times it's favorited, downloaded, the last updated date, as well as the content license. Is it in the public domain? Is it copyrighted, etc.? On the right here, you can see we have the button that will allow us to actually bring this into a course, which is the subject of another video, the size of the course item, and the ability to add it to our own favorites, as well as copy that direct link to that resource to share it out. The final screen here is the version notes, which just lists out how this resource has been updated, when it was updated, and what were the updates themselves. So within this lesson, we have looked at how you preview an item within Course Commons and what information is provided. Cheers.